As we have what could be a strong Category 4 at landfall coming up in the next few hours along the Texas-Louisiana border. Winds already at 45 miles per hour in Lake Charles as that onshore flow begins. 40-mile-per-hour winds around Sabine. Look at this monster storm. We have an eye that is basically perfectly circular. It's a well-oiled machine, as I've been mentioning. We have the outflow that helps it breathe, and it is well-organized. There's no reason to think that it is going to weaken at all, but it will likely at least maintain strength or possibly intensify as it gets toward the Louisiana-Texas border in the next few hours. Let's check the latest stats and see if any new information has come in. Right now, it still stands at 150-mile-an-hour winds, so we're not looking at the new update just yet, but we'll notice if the new update comes in, if this track jumps, because it always tends to come in during my weathercast around 10:45. So I'll let you know if we get a brand new update as I'm talking about all of this. But 2 a.m. Eastern time is when we're expecting a landfall of the storm as a Category 4. It will move inland as a tropical storm into northern Louisiana by 2 p.m. with 70-mile-per-hour winds. That's for Shreveport, well inland. So this is going to have big, far-reaching impacts from the coast. And even for areas like Tennessee, Kentucky, there's going to be a swath of heavy rain along this center track. Now, we're going to be south of it going into the day Saturday. What does that mean? Gusty wind for us, potential tornado risk depending on where that low is moving and where it meets up with some of the heat of the day. We could see a few storms get going. Computer models have been all really quite consistent keeping it north of us, but we do have this one GFS ensemble that tries to take it through our area. But just to show you, it's not 100% agreement, but there's pretty good forecast confidence in that track taking the remnants through Kentucky as well as the Virginias. So gusty wind, 30 to 40 miles per hour possible, even in the upstate. A tornado threat is a possibility as well. We'd have a short window of opportunity for that at some point on Saturday, and we'll watch out and let you know when that could be as we get a little bit closer. Late Friday is when those winds would start to pick up, and we'll feel those effects through the day on Saturday. Into the day on Thursday, though, fairly calm, just a few pop-up showers and storms possible, and it's going to be a hot one, 85 to 90, but that's about normal for this time of year. We're going to give it an 8 on the Carolina sky meter. So let's look at the long range here as the heavy rain from Laura moves onshore and moves into Arkansas as a tropical storm. Then notice how it really fades out. The heaviest of the moisture should be done. The connection to the Gulf of Mexico is going to get disrupted, so we're not going to see as heavy of rain as it tracks across Tennessee and moves toward our area. But we're going to start to tap into at least a little bit of that tropical moisture in the form of scattered storms Friday evening. This is not when we would have a tornado threat, though. It would likely be on Saturday as that center of circulation passes over. But right now, a lot of the models try to take it over us during the morning when we wouldn't have very much energy for storms. So this might spare us from the worst in the way of the severe weather. And then notice by 7 p.m., storms getting going off to our east, but we'd be in the clear. So we'd be looking at conditions really calming down late on Saturday. Want to show you, though, when winds are expected to peak going into Saturday morning, gusts at 30 miles per hour, potentially even higher than that, but would get better towards Saturday evening. So your next 7 days, notice we do have a decent storm threat going into late Friday into Saturday, but Sunday we start to clear out. By Monday, another chance for a few showers, but much calmer weather setting up second half of the weekend and beyond.